Hi everybody, welcome to the quick course on QGIS or crash course of QGIS 3. In this course, we try to learn to create a new project, georeference an image, create a vector layers like shapefiles or geopackage, edit point, lines and polygons, table management. In this part, we can see how to create and fill fields, add layers and import GPS points, geoprocessing and geometry calculation, for example, for calculated area, perimeter or length, symbology of points, lines and polygons, adding labels, and design and publishing a map. For this crash course, we use an image for georeference and generate the data. For example, in this image, you can see buildings, roads, and rivers. We try to georeference this image and create all objects that you see. Now we open QGIS 3. The first step is create a new project in Project Templates panels. Click. In QGIS, we have a menu bar, a toolbars, and panel, for example, browser, layers, or processing tools. If it's not active, we can open, click for toolbox. Now we have a new project and we need to save. Go to project, save. We need to assign a name, for example, quick course, save. The next step is to georeference an image. Go to raster menu and click on georeferencer. In this window, we need to open the image, for example, file, open raster, click on image, open, and now we have the image on georeference. For example, you can see point 1 and point 2 contain the plane coordinates for X and Y. Maybe you say, how I can get these coordinates? The fast method is identify in the image a common point, and next we need to go to the field with a GPS device, try to capture these coordinates that we need for georeference. Before to georeference, we need configurate the coordinate system. In toolbars, in yellow icon, click on transformation setting. In transformation type, we select linear. In target SRS, we need to select the system coordinate. In this case, WG is 84 UTM zone 17 south. You can see. Also, you can find your own coordinate system. In this part, we have geographic coordinate system and project coordinate system. For this case, is project coordinate system. Okay. In output settings, we need to select the name of georeference image. In this case, output raster, I choose image modified that diff. Compression none, and the all settings we leave by default. Click on OK. On the toolbar bar, click on add point. Now we need put exactly on point 1. For example, on the center, click. In these windows, we need to enter the coordinates. For example, for X, 6, 9, 1, 2, 6, 3. For north, 9, 5, 3, 2, 7, 7, 5. Click on OK. Now we have the first control point. We need to add the second control point. Click on the center. On this window, we also need to add the coordinates. For example, for X, north, check if the coordinates are correct. OK. To finalize the georeference, click on start georeference. We can see that georeference is successful. Now we can close this window, this card. For add the georeference image, in browser panel, we can explore the GIS quick course QGIS 3, and we have image modified. Double click on this image. Before to digitalize the elements like roads, rivers, and buildings, We need to create the layers. Go to layer menu, create layer. Here we have different formats for layers. For example, the most common layer is a shapefile. Click on new shapefile layer and fill name. In fill name, we need to select the directory and name for this file. For example, buildings, save, geometry type, in this case is point. The coordinate reference system for this case is WGS84UTM-70South. Okay. Next, okay. We have the building layer. The next layer, for example, for river, layer, create layer. In this case, we can choose geopackage layer, for example, or anything. For this file, we need to create a database. River, save, table name is river, no problem. Geometry type, in this case, line string. The same coordinate system is okay. Also, we need a layer for ROAS. Layer, create layer, new geopackage, database, ROAS, save, geometry type, line string, the same coordinate system, okay. Next, create layer. I can choose anything. In this case, I create a new shapefile layer. For lake, save, in geometry type, in this case is polygon, the same coordinate system is okay. Now we need to edit these layers. For example, if deactivate the georeference image, you can see nothing, but we need to digitalize this object. For example, if I want to create the buildings, right click on buildings layer and click on toggle editing. Now I am in edit mode. Remember that a layer building is a point layer. In the toolbars, click on add point feature. We can make a zoom and click on all buildings that you can see. For example, click OK, click OK, click OK, and click OK. Now I have the points for building layer. You can see. Don't forget, save the layer edit. To finalize the editing in this layer, click on toggle editing. The same things for all layers. For example, for river, right click, toggle editing, click on add line feature. In this case, I need to draw the river. For example, click, 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 click to finalize, right click, and okay. You can see I have the river layer. I repeat the process on layer. For example, right click, toggle editing, in toolbars, add line feature, and click, 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 right click, okay. For local streets, the same thing, click, right click, okay. Click, click, right click to finish the line. Okay, you can see the progress. Next, click, click. Also, while I editing, I can zoom in with the scroll. Click, right click to finish. Okay, on the image, right click, zoom to layer. We can check if we have digitalized all ROAS in this image. Click, right click, okay. If I deactivate the image, you can see all ROAS in this layer. Save, click on save layer edit, click on toggle editing, and also we need to digitalize the lakes. In this case, lake layer, right click, toggle editing, zoom in, click on add polygon feature, and to start to digitalize, click, 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 follow the boundary or borders, click, right click to finish. Okay, click, 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 click for the second like, click, Click, right click to finish. Okay, save, stop editing, right click on modify image, come to layer. If I deactivate the image, you can see all elements for this project. Now we need to add information for all layers. In this case, for example, if I deactivate all layers except buildings, we need to define, for example, if this point is a school, hospital, police, or crunch, or anything. For add information, we need to add fields in the table attribute. Right click on the layer, in this case building, open attribute table. For start editing, click on toggle editing mode, click new field, in this case, for example, type, in type text or string, in length, for example, 100 could be, or the number of characters that I need. Okay, for example, in 8th row, in column type, W click. Here we can write the name of this point, for example, hospital, other random point, 21, school, 25, police, 30, for example, charge. The next point, the rest of the points, and maybe I can rename like house. But if I do W click on type, for example, I can select all points. In this part, when you see the numbers 1, 2, 3, I can choose the column, for example, or field type. In this part, open single quotes. Between single quotes, I need to write the name, for example, house, close single quotes, and click and update selects. In this form, you can see that all rows get this information, house. Save editing, stop editing with toggle editing mode, and now we have all information for building layer. For clearance selection, we can use the deselect feature from all layers button. In river layer, maybe we don't need to add attribute because we have only one element. For road, we have different kind of element. Right click, open attribute table. In this case, I can move the attribute table windows, and you can use select feature button. For example, click, click. I have select this element in this layer. In this case, also we need to activate for start editing, toggle editing mode. We need to add a new file type, name, in type, text or string, the length 100 is okay. Here we can write the type of this road. For example, could be rural roads. If select this road, also we can, a good way to input the data is use the doc attribute table. For example, if I select this road, I need to find in the attribute table 17. This is, for example, I can activate the mesh. For example, could be unpaved road. Also, this road is the same, unpaved roads. Activate the mesh. And these roads could be local streets. For example, I can draw a rectangle to select these roads. And here I choose type. Between single quotes, I write local streets, close single quotes, click on update select. This action is only for selects objects. With update all, add this information for all column or for all field. Click update select, save, stop editing. I can close the attribute table. Clear selection and activate other layers like rivers and building, and we have this layer with respective information. Other option that we have in QGIS is add our layers. For example, in this directory, I have this layer named contour 20 contour lines. Come back to QGIS. And for all this layer, I can use the Open Data Source Manager button. Here I have the browser, the same panel, the same option for the browser I have here. Also, I can choose vector, layer, mesh, point, or text option to add information. In this case, I prefer to use the browser. For example, I go to GIS, Quick Course, QGIS stream, double click on Contour 20s, close this window. In here, I have the contour lines. Also, we can import our data from GPS points. For example, in this folder, I have GPS points. If I want to add these coordinates in QGIS, it's very simple. I have different options. For me, it's more easy if I select all data, copy, and paste in Notepad. Also, we can export from Excel in CSV or any plain text format. Notepad and paste. File, edit, paste. Here I have the data. Save this file like GPS point. Save. Come back to QGIS. Go to layer. Add layer. Add delimited text layer. In file name, we need to search the GPS point.txt. Open. In file format, it's important that you choose the correct delimiters. For example, in this case, it's for tab. Also, you can choose for colon, space, comma, semicolon, others. You can see an example for the table for coordinates X and Y and record and field options. If the comma is a decimal separator, you can mark this option. Only if decimal separator is a comma. In this case, it's a point. Uncheck this field. In geometry definition, point coordinate, X field, I choose point X, Y field, point Y. In geometry CRS, we need to choose the correct coordinate system. In this case, it's correct, WGS 84 UTM SOM 17 South. Add, close, we have the GPS point. For example, if I deactivate building layer, you can see GPS point. Other important aspect in QGIS is the geoprocessing in geometry calculation. If I want to know the measure of the dam of this river, we need to add a field to calculate the length. For example, right click on river, open attribute table, edit mode, new field, name length, meters, and type, could be in decimal, it's okay. Now, I need to select the field length meters. In this part, in this field, I delete all data and click in this equation icon. Here I have a lot of expression which I can calculate some geometry. For example, in geometry, I need to find length, double click, OK. Update all. In here I have the length in meters. If I want in kilometers, I need to divide by 1000. For example, divide by 1000. Update. I have in kilometers. Update all. Save and stop editing. And here I have the length. For example, if I want to calculate the area and perimeter for these lakes, right click on lake, open attribute table, start editing mode, click on new file, area, and type decimal, it's okay. Also, I want the perimeter as field, new field, perimeter, decimal number, or also you can choose a whole number, okay. For example, if I want to calculate the area, select area, equation icon, I need to find the expression for calculate the area. I go to geometry and I find here area. Double click. OK. Update all. I have the area in meters. For perimeter, I choose perimeter field. In equation, clear all. In geometry, I find the function for perimeter. Here I have perimeter. Okay. Update. Save. Stop editing. Can I close the table? In GeoProcess, I have a lot of tools for do this. For example, in GPS point, I want to make an influence area. For this thing, I need to make a buffer. Go to vector, geometry, geoprocessing tools, buffer. In input layer, I need to select the layer that I want make an influence area. For example, buffer, GPS point, the distance, 30, could be meters, kilometers, feet, miles, yards, in this case meters. Click on run, close, and I have the area of influence for GPS point. For example, in this folder, I have a digital elevation model, and then double click. You can see a raster file for elevation. For example, if I want to create contour lines in processing tools, I can find contour line option. For example, I need to write contour. I have in GDEL raster extraction contours. Double click. Input layer, I need to choose the digital elevation models. And interval contour lines, in this case 5 meters is okay. Click on run, close, and here I have contour line for 5 meters. It's important that you can try to use different tools for any things. Also, if you want give more power to QGIS, we have the plugins in Manager and Install Plugins. We have a lot of plugins for add more functions in QGIS. Also, in Digital Elevation Model, we can make a hill shade. For example, in Processing Toolbox, I write hill shade. In Elevation Layer, I need to select the Digital Elevation Model and click on Run. Close. If I deactivate Dim Layer, you can see the hill shade layer where we can see the relief of the terrain for this area. When we have all layers ready, we can apply a symbology for points, lines, and polygons. Before to publish the map, it's necessary to rename all layers with the correct name. For example, like is correct, contours, right click, rename layer, buffer is correct, GPS point, right click, rename. Right click, rename, contour lines, 20 meters, road is correct, hill shade is correct, river is correct, and building is correct. At this time, we need design who layers we want to show to make a map. I don't want to use dim, contour lines 20. Also, we can pat the hill shade on the top. We can drag and drop hill shade, right click, properties. In layer properties, we can use the transparency option. For example, here I put a 10%, apply. You can see the topographic effect. You can play with this value. For example, 50%. Okay. For example, if I want categorize the building layer, right click, properties, symbology, and single layer chain to categorize. In value, I need to select the field that contain all information, in this case type classify, and here we can see all categories in this field. For example, all others I can remove or delete and click apply. Okay, for buildings, I have in categories. If I want to change the icon with W click on the icon, we can select a symbol, for example, okay, for house, okay, for police, and for school. Okay, next for GPS point, this is okay. I can recommend that polygons, you can drag and drop on the bottom, lines in the middle, and point in front of all layers. Other option to customize the symbology is with layer styling. If it's not active, this panel, you can go to View, Panels, Layer Styling. And we have layer styling. Simple, it's very easy. We need to select the layers. In the panel, we can select the bed symbol for this layer. In this case, this gray line is okay. But the width I can reduce. I think is okay. For ROAS, click on ROAS, single symbol, chain for categorize, and value, type, click here, and classify. I can remove this category, all other values, or delete. Also, I can customize the symbol for each street, for example, local street, W click, and I think is okay this. For rural roads, this is okay. And for unpaved roads, I can choose, for example, this. Okay. For river, the same. I need to choose the correct symbol. For example, this is nice. Also, I can change the color here. Apply. We can also add labels. If I open the attribute table of river layers, for example, open attribute table. If I want to show the name, for example, Malacatos River, right click, properties. In labels, in no labels, I choose single labels and I select the field that contain the labels. For example, name. Apply, you can see the name. For example, I can customize the text, the color I need to change for blue. Okay. For lakes, click in blue. And for buffer, also I can select any symbol, for example, this. And finally, if all things are correct, looks good, we can design the map for publishing or print. We need to save the project. Next, go to project menu. Click on new print layout. My map, for example. Okay. And here we have other windows for design the map. In vertical toolbar, we have the option add map. Click, and we need to draw a rectangle for the map. For example, I think is correct. If you want to add a north arrow, click here and draw the north arrow. This icon is for the legend. If I want add to legend, click and draw. Also, we need a scale bar. For example, click here and draw the scale bar. For add a title, click on text label, add label, and draw the title. We have all elements for the map. For customize this element in the right panel for items, we have the option to customize. For example, for map, click. I can select the scale, for example, 5000 is okay. I can adjust the size. If I want to move the content, I can do with move content icon, locate here, move item content, move the content free. For me, here is correct. Next, we need to add the grid. For example, if I scroll down with the arrows, I have other options. For example, grids, click, add a grid, a new grid, modify grid. Here I can select the interval for grids. For example, 200 meters. For me, it's okay. Also, I can choose the line style. For example, a gray. Okay. I can play with the width. 0.1. For me, it's correct. Come back. So we can add a frame. For example, line border. Also, we can draw the coordinates. Click here, and we have the coordinates. For left, I prefer vertical, and for right, I want vertical. If I zoom in, you can see decimals. If you want to remove, in coordinate precision, you can pad 0. Now it's better. Click here to zoom full. I select the object, and I can't move. For me, it's nice. For the scale bar, I need to move. I think that is okay. The north arrow is okay here. And for customize the legend, click on legend. If I want delete some layers that I don't want to show in legend items, uncheck auto updates, and I can delete some layer. For example, hill shade, I want remove, click and remove. Then remove, and GPS point is correct, building is correct, contour lines 20, remove, ROAS is correct, and river is correct, contour lines is correct, lake buffer is correct, and image modified I want remove. For example, if I made some change in QGIS, I can update with this button, refresh view, and reflect all changes that I did in the map. Finally, I need to modify the title in text. For example, I can put my first map in QGIS 3. The appearance, I can change the font, the size, I think is correct on the center. If I want to add a logo or picture, you can choose this option, add picture, draw, and item properties for picture, you can choose raster image, and we can find in our local disk. For example, logo, open, and here I have an image. Well, and finally, we can print or export the image. If you want to print, simple click in print layout, or you can export like image, SVG, or PDF. In this case, I will export as image. My map, save. And here I have the director for my map. For example, I have here the result from the first image, where we have a lot of elements. And now we have in vector elements, digitalized buildings, roads, rivers, and lakes. Well, if you like this video, you can subscribe in my channel and give me a like on this video. Thanks a lot for staying here. Have a nice day and see you soon.